Do you see the dead animals? You can't see them, can you? But they're there. Gummy bears and other gummy candies are made with gelatin, which comes from boiling the bones of animals. So cool! It's like witchcraft. When you boil animal bones, hooves, cartilage, and skin, you can extract the collagen that's holding everything together. And then that collagen gets hydrolyzed into gelatin. And since gelatin is colorless, odorless, and flavorless, it's the perfect secret ingredient. You'd never guess it was there. But if gelatin has no flavor, then why did we start eating it in the first place? Well, we didn't at first. In its earliest uses, gelatin was used as glue. Traces of gelatin have been found in a pharaoh's grave, gluing the different parts together. But we've come a long way since ancient Egyptian times. Nowadays, we know how to make bad things taste good, including glue. The modern food industry has shown us that if you add enough sugar and flavorings, you can make anything taste good. And that's exactly what we've done with gelatin. In the 1800s, industrialist Peter Cooper took out a patent on his new gelatin dessert powder, which would eventually become Jell-O. But at the time, he wasn't trying to make dessert. See, Cooper owned a glue factory, so he was already used to using animal bones and hooves to produce glue when he stumbled upon dessert. How lucky for us! Without him, we would never have known how good glue can taste. Gelatin dessert revolutionized the realm of possibility for what we can eat, or I should say, who we can eat, without even knowing we're eating them. I mean, we all love animals. That's why we make our candy into the shape of animals in the first place. So we can look at these cute little bears and forget all about the pigs and cows and fishes who were killed and boiled up to produce this candy. These bears look so cute and innocent, you'd never guess the murder that goes into making them. And who would guess that that yummy gumminess is coming from the same gelatinous animal ingredients that are used to make glue? And you can make gelatin too. Just take an animal carcass left over, if you know, have one hanging around, and boil it up for hours and hours until you extract the collagen. Hip bones and knuckle bones are the best to use because there's a lot of joints and connective tissue, which is where collagen comes from. And collagen isn't just useful for making foods gelatinous. You can inject collagen into your face to make yourself gelatinous too. When you get collagen injections to fill wrinkles or make your lips bigger, doctors often use bovine collagen, which comes from boiling up the bones and hides of cows who were killed for meat. So you can carry a little piece of their dead body around in your face and mouth. Isn't collagen cool? We've found so many ways to use it. And even though nowadays glue is often made from cheaper synthetic materials, we're still clinging to the old traditions of abusing animals for the candy that we feed our children. You can find gummy candies that are made without gelatin, but that's no fun. What's really fun is biting into the gummy, chewy, gelatinous texture of boiled up bones and hides and knowing that there was a little dead animal in every bite. Well, let me know what cool products you want me to review next.